What is going on, guys? Gabsito here, bringing you a League of Legends commentary. And today I'm playing top lane with Jax. And it's been a while since I made a normal commentary. I felt that I should probably do that. So I picked Jax top. It's usually been, or the latest videos, it's been you choose, I play episodes for the commentaries. So I haven't made a normal one in a while. Playing along the meta, but I guess I'd have to do that now. So I'm gonna get the first blood or first kill here pretty soon. Wukong is gonna come into turret range and get a shot there, so I'm gonna go in on him and I'm gonna flash with my stun and get him. He's gonna flash away and try to juke me here in the rush, but that's not gonna matter. I'm just gonna jump after him and pick him off. So that's very nice, get a good start versus that Wukong, because he is very strong. Even with this kill, I'm a little bit afraid to go in versus him, so that was really good that I got the first blood. So heading back top, I haven't played top at all since the new map came, because I haven't played much League of Legends, to be honest. I've played some CSGO, Counter-Strike, but I'm gonna get back to League of Legends when the, you know, it's pre-season now. I'm not sure when the next season starts. It's season 5, I think, but I'm gonna try to play some ranked games in pre-season as well, because they do kind of matter in when you get picked for when you get what is it called, when they put you in different, you know, leagues and divisions. They do matter, the preseason games. If you're, for example, if you're gold in the preseason, or if you were gold the previous season, that is going to be taken into account when you play those 10 games. And they look, I think I was gold this season. So, I think it would be impossible for me to end up in bronze next season, even if I lose basically every game. I'm not really sure, but I don't think bronze can happen. So I could stay in gold if I do pretty well, or you could go down to silver, or maybe up to plat, depending on where you are in gold. Yeah, it depends. I'm gonna get the second kill here on Wukong, I think. He's gonna try to juke me once again. He's gonna ult, but that's not gonna matter much. I'm gonna flash after. I'm gonna be able to get the kill. Hecarim is gonna come in here, and I'm just gonna Q away. He is gonna smite me there, and I'm not sure why that didn't slow, because he usually slows. I don't know if that's something you buy. I'm not really informed about all the new updates to this game and stuff that's been happening lately, but I just discovered that Soraka has been reworked or nerfed or changed, whatever you want to say, and I kind of don't like that. I've said that I don't like changes to the game or changes at all in general. I'm that type of person that don't like changes, but they changed Soraka and she's pretty bad right now. I don't know, it's probably a good change for that, but I mean, she was so fun. I didn't play her much, but she was fun, you know, using that, spamming that Q and getting those stacks and stuff. You could hit multiple enemies with it. Now it's a skill shot and you have like, it's not very nice. I don't like it. And it also heals her. You can't heal yourself with the heal as you could before, I think, but you can heal your allies as usual, but you, it's basically almost a spell vamp spell, so if you hit your Q on an enemy, you get some health back, and the more enemies you hit, the more health, and it also depends on how much health you have. It's like a percentage of your health or something. I'm gonna go in here on Lucian. He's gonna flash, and I do a good job on retreating here because Hecarim and Ahri was there. If they were a little bit more ready there, they could have maybe turned and killed me if Ahri, you know, came in with her ult and Shardmi and Hecarim just jumped at me. That could have been a kill. So it's almost Christmas, guys. How does that feel? It's not even snow here. It doesn't feel like Christmas because here in Sweden it doesn't even snow. I remember last Christmas we didn't even have snow on Christmas Day. It has to be snow on Christmas. I think in the United States they celebrate Christmas the 25th. We celebrate it 24th. And there was no snow last year. It was just raining. It might have been snow, but it was raining. And this winter, it hasn't even snowed once. I haven't seen snow in such a long time. It feels weird. I don't even know what it looks like. What color is it? Is it green? I don't know. You gotta inform me. Please type in the comment. Do you know what snow is? Please tell me. I don't even know. I'm gonna go in for Illusion here. And we're gonna get that kill. And this is actually a pretty big turning point in the game. Or I might have killed people earlier, but I forgot to talk about that. However, we're gonna turn here. I thought I was dead there, but Ahri is pretty squishy, so I managed to turn that around. Wukong is gonna get caught here, and we're gonna be able to pick that kill up as well. Sona is gonna be chased here. No, she's not. We're just gonna take the mid turret, I guess. So yeah, I think I'm gonna go back to base here instead. Usually when I play Jax, I can talk a little bit about the build. I build Trinity Force and Blade of the Ruined King simultaneously. You should go for the Phage and the Bilgewater Cutlass thing at the same time, almost. You could prioritize what you want, but it's pretty good. I could have gotten Hecarim here a couple of times, but he just keeps getting healed, shielded, and everything. And if I killed him earlier, we could have taken out Lucian as well, and then Sona with no mana wouldn't be a problem. That fight was really, really lucky that Hecarim didn't die earlier. So that was a bit unfortunate, but you should build the Trinity Force and the Blade of the Ruined King at the same time, the lifesteal thing and the Phage for tankiness and AD. And then you could go for some attack speed. There's attack speed on both the Blade of the Ruined and the Trinity Force. And don't hate me for this. I don't even know. Maybe one of those items got nerfed or something. I haven't followed everything in this game, as you can tell. Maybe Trinity Force got nerfed or Blade of the Ruined King got nerfed. You can tell me if you know anything about it. It's just the few weeks or latest weeks or months I haven't been following on updates and patch notes and everything that you should be doing. But I'm getting to it. I looked at the patch notes, the latest patch notes. But you know, I was really surprised when they nerfed Soraka. I was gonna play her for a You Choose I Play episode, and then I realized she is pretty bad. I don't even know if I want to play that. So I could have stayed there and tried to, you know, last hit the kill on Ahri, but I decided to leave that to my team, who stayed there to last hit that kill. I'm gonna chase down Sona and kill her instead, so that's gonna be two kills instead of just everyone staying at the same spot trying to last hit the same kill, which anyone could have gotten alone. Alistar is going to be chased down here, and they're going to surrender, actually, and that's going to be the end of the game. I guess they actually had that game for the most part, but then I got so fed, so they decided, fuck it, let's surrender. We can't win versus Capcito. He's too OP. Can't do that. So victory for us. Merry Christmas. This is going to be the last video before Christmas. Merry Christmas. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Peace. Have a good Christmas.
Right, there's nobody that I can transfer you to, unfortunately.
But I need to speak to some bonus who can speak the Chinese.
Right, there's no, like I said, there's nobody that I can transfer you to, unfortunately.